You know, I started to write the Not For Sale book after going to 5 continents, 90,000 miles, and monitoring, investigating where modern slavery today can be found. The thing that really surprised me was I had heard a great deal about sex slavery and young children and women who were forced into the brothel industry. But the thing that really surprised me is how many people in the world today are forced into what we used to call bonded labor or slavery, where someone would be bought and sold for the very purpose of using their labor. In India, you'll go to a rice mill and you'll find hundreds of people of all ages, old and young, who work 7 days a week and they are not paid. They are forced to work there. They are violently threatened if they try to leave. And they might work their whole lifetime and never be able to leave because the owner of the rice mill or the brick kiln or the rug factory will say that, you owe me. You're in debt to me and I own your body until you can come up with money to free yourself. Not For Sale was an investigation not only of trafficking, but it was also an investigation of the abolitionist. I call them modern day Underground Railroad folks who are building ways to free slaves and also ways to keep them free once they're out of captivity. These were men and women in Peru and India and Cambodia, Thailand, here in the United States. And they worked in order to free people and find ways that we could resist the global slave trade.